Rendered by Jagjit Singh and Chitra Singh from the film Saath Saath. You're with us on the General Overseas Service of All India Radio. It's time now for a review of editorial comments from the Indian press. The script is by Dr. Moinuddin Khan, journalist, and it is read by Lucy Chattopadhyay.
This is All India Radio.
The news
read by Meenakshi Sa.
In Syria, the opposition Syrian Observatory for Human Rights said that more than 200 people were killed in shelling by Syrian forces in the city of Homs. Rami Abdul Rahman, head of the Duncan Lake activist group citing witnesses, said at least 217 people were killed in Homs, among which 138 in the Khadija district alone. The observatory said the Saudi forces dispersed protests in the Jinnab al-Malab district of Hamas, where people had planned to gather to mark the uprising in 1982, which was pushed by Hafiz al-Assad's regime. In Somalia, opposition fighters, including eight top al-Shabaab commanders, have been killed in the latest battle in the town northeast of Baghdad.
I beg your pardon, of Wadadi.
The country's military spokesman has said Kenyan helicopter gunshots hit at al-Shabaab positions yesterday, killing at least 100 fighters and destroying 9 technicals and 9 trucks used by the fighters. He said the Kenyan troops advanced into the town of Badali and Hayu in southern Somalia, boosting their chances for a successful battle for the port of Kismayu and the town of Asmadaw, a provincial capital, and key hub of al-Shabaab, which is one of the main ultimate targets of the operation. Kenyan troops have been on the ground in Somalia since October last year against the al-Shabaab militants who have been mounting armed incursions into Kenya. In Russia, thousands of people are marching in the capital, Moscow, in protest against Prime Minister Vladimir Putin's grip on power. It is the third rally since December's parliamentary elections marked by allegations of vote rigging. About 23,000 people are taking part in the march from Kolomskaya Square to Bolotnaya Square in the city. The organizers of today's protests are demanding a rerun of December's election and calling on people to vote against Putin in the next month's presidential election. Iran's Islamic Revolution Guard Corps started a military drill near its southern waters today. The commander of the corps' ground forces, Brigadier General Mohammad Babar, said the whole thing is aimed at keeping and promoting the readiness of forces to confront any threat. He did not specify the accurate location and duration of the drill. However, Iran already announced that its exercises in the southern waters or near the sea, near the area, are aimed at maintaining readiness to confront threats in the Persian Gulf, the Sea of Oman, and the Strait of Hormuz, which is an important passage for the oil tankers. Iran has threatened to close the strait if it cannot send oil in the face of Western sanctions on the oil exports of the Islamic Republic. Iran Defense Minister Brigadier General Ahmed Vahidi today opened the mass production line of naval Zafar cruise missile. The state TV today reported that the anti-vessel short-range missile equipped with radar systems is able to hit small and average-sized targets with high precision. The report said the missile can be mounted on light and fast-moving vessels and has high capability in electronic wars with high destructive power. According to the report, the missile is totally native and it is designed and constructed by Iranian experts. In a major relief to Minister Peter Dhumrum and the UK government, a Delhi court has dismissed a petition seeking to make him an accused in the Toti case. The petition was filed by the Janata Party President Subramanian Swamy. Rejecting his petition, the CBI special judge of Sain said in New Delhi today that Chidambaram did not indulge in any criminal conspiracy or derive any pecuniary advantage in the decisions taken with former telecom minister E. Rama. In a 64-page judgment, the judge gave a clean chit to the then finance minister at the time of the controversial allocation of 2G spectrum in 2008 and said Chidambaram was party to only two decisions, keeping spectrum prices at 2001 level and dilution of equity by two companies. The special court said there is no evidence on record that Chidambaram was acting in pursuit of the criminal conspiracy. And now, to end this bulletin, here are the main points. In Syria, over 200 people killed in the shelling and the setting of Homs. In Somalia, at least 100 fighters, including eight top al-Shabaab commanders, killed in the latest battle in a town northeast of Baghdad. Iran's Islamic Revolution Guards Corps start a military drill near its southern waters. And that is the end of this thing's bulletin.
We are now closing down this transmission from the General Overseas Service of All India Radio. We will be back on the air for our listeners in East and Southeast Asia
on 9,705 kHz on the 31-meter band, 6,055 kHz on the 49-meter band, and 7,305 kHz on the 41-meter band at 0450 hours Indian Standard Time, that is at 2245 hours UTC. Until then, we thank you for joining us.